Now, ladies and gentlemen, I am so ready for this lobster. This is a real nice clam bake or oyster bake, whatever. I feel like I'm in Carousel. Look at all this fabulous food. What do we have here, Al?
So we have a variety of things. We're here in Captain Lavender's deck, which is one of the more popular spots in the evening in Provincetown.
Love that name, Captain Lavender.
It's an outdoor covered environment. We have heaters in here, so when it gets a little bit cool, even in the middle of summer, the heaters go on. And, of course, the full bar and
nearby.
So what we have here is an oyster plate, and you're sampling Wellfleet oysters, which are our local oyster. You'll find them a little bit briny, a little bit salty, but they're one of the most favored.
Should I taste one?
Sure.
I can do this. These are genuine oysters. Wellfleet, you said?
These are from Wellfleet. You can just, right, you can see the beds across the bay.
Oh, I love oysters. I love them. Love them. So what do we have over here?
And then we have our seafood platter, which is a variety of shellfish. We have oysters, of course. We have little neck clams, which are my favorite. I think the little necks are sweeter than the cherry stones. They're my favorite. Some shrimp and a lobster's tail.
And what kind of oysters are these? Are they the same as these?
I believe those are James River. That are
from Canada?
They're from the mid-Atlantic states. They're from Maryland.
Maryland. All right, let's just have a oyster fest here. I'll try this one. Am I doing this right? Am I getting it?
There's no wrong way to do it.
There's no wrong way to eat an oyster, ladies and gentlemen. And the taste is totally different.
So, of course, the way that a pro eats an oyster is...
Yes, you show us.
Take a little bit of the sauce, the horseradish, and then it's a slurping.
Oh, love it, love it.
And when you get all the juice and all the all the goodness.
I've been eating them wrong all these years. Okay, now we know. It's an educational program today on the Stephen Holt Show. And what is this lovely dish, Al?
And this is our seafood cop salad. It has shrimp, it has crab meat, a variety, some bacon and avocado and greens and tomato. And this is always a favorite for lunch. And then...
What's this?
is a Cosmo made with our own infusion. We infuse our own liquors here. So one of the infusions that we do is, of course, we're on Cape Cod. Cranberries are all over the place. And we do a cranberry-infused vodka. Let the cranberries infuse in the vodka for at least 3 weeks. And it really makes the best Cosmo that you've ever had. It's tart, not sweet. And you really taste those Cape Cod cranberries. We also do a watermelon-infused tequila. We do a jalapeno-infused vodka. But those change up all the time. We do a pineapple-infused rum.
You must have a busy bar downstairs in the evenings.
It's quite fun, but they make fabulous drinks. So you really take on the flavor of the fruit.
The drink is almost as big as my hand. My goodness gracious. And we've got something else coming now, which I think we'll just sort of... Oh, and this gentleman's name is...
This is Joe.
Joe, hey Joe. Joe is responsible for all of this. Oh my God.
Look at this lovely cocktail.
Look at this.
Our house clam bake. Pound and a quarter native lobster, native mussels, local clams, corn on a cob, and just a little twist on, we have some tri-colored fingerling potatoes. And of course, the drawn butter.
Okay, and I'm always bad at opening and deshelling lobsters, so I won't ask you to do that unless you feel like it.
I can do that for you.
Well, why don't we do that? That always looks really good on TV, so let's do that.
You're putting me on the spot, but okay, good thing I have a towel. I'm going to make a little room.
The drama bills have to move the Cosmo.
I may need a Cosmo. You're going to need the towelettes.
So we can see this.
Pardon my hands.
Is this the same lobster we saw a few minutes ago? when he was alive.
You can pick them. Some people, customers, do like to pick them for whatever reason. So this kind of is very easy, yeah.
Okay, we're breaking them there.
Yeah, obviously, we have the claws, the knuckle meat, the sweetest, the tail, which, with the cocktail fork, you can eat right out as you like, or crack it further.
You're getting so hungry out there, aren't you?
I hope you love lobster.
I love lobster.
Oh, you're gonna love, there you go. So use the cocktail fork and
just dig right in here.
Dig right in. You have your butter.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, fresh from the sea, across the street. Mmm. Oh my goodness. I just can't stop eating this. Is this some more?
There you go. Yep, that's for you.
And that's the best meat out of the claw and out of the tail.
I did not know that.
Now, there is meat in the body, but that just takes that right a lot of work.
I think you should dip that right in and go for it. Your order is claw on that one. Good stuff.
Made nice.
Take this down now. There you go.
I never could do this myself. Never.
It's actually pretty easy, you know. I think people are intimidated a little bit with them, and they think it's a lot of work. It's really not, you know. Just have to know where to do it.
I can't eat this and put it in my mouth, so I'm just going to leave it here for a second.
There you go. You have a knife there, you can cut it off, and that's it. Some more very sweet meat, the knuckle part.
Right.
Enjoy. I'm going to clear the mess.
I can't do it.
Thank you, Joe.
You're welcome.
Joe, thank you so much. And I'm like, oh, here we go. This is a little too big for my mouth, but I'll just dip it in the jar. Ow, thank you so much. And of course you have to have a napkin for the butter. What a lobster feast.
And a little wet nap after you finished.
Well, thank you so much here at the Waterford Inn. You must stay here. Obviously you're going to after all this.
You're very welcome.
And everyone is welcome.
Everyone certainly is.
And you've got to make reservations. Do you have a number that they can call, or what's the best way to make this?
508-487-6400. 508-487-6400.
And you've got to book in advance, because people book this place like a year in advance. Is that right? Yeah. I heard.
We're pretty booked July, you know, many weekends. So, you know, starting Memorial Day on, it kind of gets a little bit hectic.
And there's that song from Carousel I'm remembering. June, 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 just because it's June, 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 which is, of course, the big wedding month, so the wedding is going on here every weekend.
Every weekend in June, every weekend in September. Actually, one of the things that we do, it's a fabulous place to have weddings, is we have this covered area. We can host up to 50 people.
Oh, wow.
We did a wedding last weekend. We're doing another wedding this weekend. So we do, it's a great place because you don't have to worry about the weather. The weather is inclement, the sides come down, you still kind of have an outdoor environment, and it's a real New England experience.
The weather is always wonderful at the Waterford Inn. Thank you so much.
Very well.
Thank you so much at the Waterford Inn, and have a fabulous... Oh.